that a person really goes to work and he doesn't have the right hashkafas. He doesn't remember that she's doing only a shtadlis and the real parnasa comes from Hashem. Is he apikoros for that? No. Nobody ever said that. Of course, you could say he's wrong for living like that, for thinking like that, but it's not apikoros, because he's influenced by the derech ha-teva, which, of course, Hashem wants us to raise ourselves above the teva. But if he didn't raise himself above the teva, you still can't call him an apikoros for that. So the same thing is over here. So Hashem said, I'm the one that makes the gula. But a person has a natural rotten to make his own thing. So they made their own thing. Does that mean that they're kofer in this? It seems to be the same thing. Only what? It's over on the Shalosh Shavuos. But why is it apikoros? So it's a pele. And I saw later that there's a kuntres from Rabbi Yoel Kahn, Man HaChochem. And I was mechavim to what he is. He asks the same thing. I didn't read that. I read the whole kuntres very superficially. I can't say over too much from it. And he's very analytical, Rabbi Yoel Kahn. Which is interesting that Rabbi Yoel Kahn is going against Rabbi Yoel Teitelbaum. It's like a min b'mino in a certain way. And he asked, but at this much I saw that he asked this question, why is it apikoros? Now, it's tamua b'yosha, but I want to say something after seeing that story. And it got me thinking. So I was thinking, you have to have a different approach to this union. Of course, the darkest of Torah is that you have to analyze everything that you come across. Everything that you read and everything that you learn, you have to analyze. And even if Gedolim from previous generations said something, you're allowed to leave it by a tzorichin. Of course, you're supposed to talk b'derech kovod, but you're allowed to leave it b'tzorichin and say, I don't understand it, and it's hard to understand this. And it's hard to even accept certain things, maybe, because we don't understand it. That's the darkest of Torah. But we have to know one thing. It's not a match. Rav Shlomo Aviner with this Admirov, it's not a match. Because you have to know, what is this Sefer Vayoyim Moshe? We have to know that this Admirov was a Kodosh. A Kodosh Elyon he was. I'm just bringing one story where you could see it, but there must be many stories. But he was a person that when he saw this rod that came down to the world, the Zionism is the biggest, one of the biggest ro'os, the bad, evil things that happened to Klal Yisrael, Beruchnius, maybe Begashmius, there was bigger tzores, but Beruchnius, this is the kiyum of the Pasuk, Ma'asayich Ma'achrivayich Mimeich Yetzeyu. Those that they made a Chorban, they came out of you. From the Jews themselves came people that they destroyed. They made a Chorban, and that never was. We suffered in all generations from the Goyim. But this is the first time in history that there was such a tremendous Chorban that Jews themselves made the Chorban. Jews themselves made a movement and a state that should say to Hashem, get out of here, we don't want you. We want to have run our own union without you, Chas v'Sholom, Rachmona Litzlan. The High Court of the State of Israel that they call the Beit Mishpat Elyon is people that are saying to Hashem, what can we do to drive you out of here? What can we do to be Goyim? are Jewish people, that we're Hashem's nation. These people that are sitting up there, that's what they want to do. Let's be goyim and let's make laws that make us goyim. And when you see such a thing, such a holy person, such a kedusha, and he was burning. He was burning like a fire. And he started shooting arrows in all sides in his sefer Vayomoshe. And I once had a friend, a Satmar Chosid. His name was Shlomo Rosenberger. And he told me, and he remembered by Shalashudis, by the Satmar Rov, when he used to say Torah, and he would talk about the Rishoyim, the Zionists, and he would talk and talk, and this person told me that he remembers going out from the Shalashudis by him, thinking that, mamish, the world came to an end. What's going to be? It's a Chorban. What's going to be? Is there going to be a Klal Yisrael? Is there going to be a world? Is there going to be any holiness left? That's the feeling that he got. No, when such a fire is burning. And he starts shooting arrows on all sides against the Ra. So you're going to bring a person like that, Rav Aviner, and he's going to start analyzing, and he's going to start saying with his gentle voice, with a slight French accent, he's going to start saying, I think like this, I think like that. What kind of match is it to the Satmarov? So right. I'm saying we have to know what's happening here. Of course, the darker shelter is that you analyze everything.
Rabbi Kaplan.
What?
Let me just say a word here. Yehudua, Rabbi, if you mentioned Rabbi Aviner, he is a Talmid Mufak, and his Rebbe, his great Rebbe is Rabbi Cook. And in this whole 400-page Sefer, which I have in my hand right now,
His Rebbe is Rav Cook.
That Rav Cook talks about the three O's, his Rebbe, and that he holds of the three O's, at least one of the three O's, Halacha Lamaisa.
Yeah, but yes.
414 pages.
Okay. You don't know exactly. You don't. Just because Rav Cook mentioned it in passing, it doesn't mean that he agrees to everything it says in the Vayomoshe.
Not everything, but there's such a... In the whole book, you want
to follow. I don't know if Rabbi Aviner is coming to say that there's no such thing as Shalosh Shavuos. Maybe he's saying that the Zionists weren't over on the Shalosh Shavuos. I didn't look so good in his safe. So who said that? I don't know. Maybe you're right. But let's get back to what I'm saying. So we have to know that what's happening here is that a fire is burning and burning. Looking at such Ra and trying to say, to show what kind of Ra this Ra is. So what are you, a small person, coming along to say, made a mistake here, made a mistake there? I'm saying, even if he did make mistakes, but that's not the point. The point is that he was a fire that was burning. Bishaz, he saw such Ra. And we are not burning like that because we're small people. And the generation has to be thankful that there was such a person, there was such a tzaddik around. And who knows, if there wouldn't be such a person, maybe we might have all got swallowed up by the tomb of Zionism. Of course, there was a Chazanish, there was a Briskerov, and Tak also, and there's Chus also, that they were for what they said and the way they fought it. So it's all part of the of what makes us be Erlich Yidden in Eretz Yisrael today. And this chus of these tzaddikim. So what is he coming along and saying like this? Good. It's hard to be marich. I just wanted to say one thing in the name of the Chofetz Chaim. I saw a story that there was some yeshiva baba that came to the Chofetz Chaim, and the Chofetz Chaim sat him down and said, "Here, I want to give you a meal you should eat." He didn't want to eat, so he said, "Oh, no, I don't have to eat." The Chofetz Chaim said, "Well, how could you not eat? We need strength. We have to be strong." He says, "There's such chil Hashem going on in the world nowadays. How could we be so good? How could we stand it if we need strength to be able to stand the chil Hashem that's going on in the world?" You see, the same thing al tzaddikim, they were. The Chofetz Chaim, when he said such a thing, he didn't just say it just to sound frum, to sound holy. The Chofetz Chaim meant it with the deepest depth of his heart, he meant it. So we have to know that there were tzaddikim, that in their schuz we are here in Eretz Yisrael today, and we're still Erlach HaYidin. I read that Rav Mordechai Pogromansky, after the war, he told people not to go to Eretz Yisrael. He said, "You don't know if you'll be able to hold in Yiddishkeit over there. There's such Rishoyim over there." And then he heard that the Chazanish tells people they should come to Eretz Yisrael. So he said, "I'm a vato my das to the Chazanish." That's what he said. That's time our godless in itself. He was also a big person. He could have said, "I think different." No. Mevatel himself to the Chazanish. Akoponim. We have to know that all these gedolim and tzaddikim, it's all a kiyum of the pasuk. V'af gamzos b'yosem b'eretzivim. Lomahastim l'galtim l'chalosam l'fabrisitim. Ki'ani Hashem elokeyim. Zeh b'shem adeti lehem, the Gemara says, shel beis rebbe v'chachmei adorus. Hashem is ma'amit us, the beis rebbe and the chachmei adorus. That's the lomahastim l'galtim. In the Golas, Hashem gave us Akim. In the darkest Golas of the Dor Achron, Hashem gave us Akim through the Gedolim and the Tzaddikim. And we have to be thankful that we were Zoche to have a Shaychus to them and be Mekabel from them, be Mavato Adas to them. And we should be Zoche the Bekor of Mashiach should come. And we shouldn't have to talk this talk anymore.
Amen v'amen. Thank you, Rabbi Kaplan. Mm-hmm.